What do you think of when you hear the phrase game? Maybe you think of your favorite childhood board game, or maybe you think of an athletic competition. Maybe you think of the games people play in their everyday social interactions. All of these, as well as countless other scenarios, are accurate notions of a game. But what ties them together? The answer is that all games involve more than one decision maker. Game theory is a tool for analyzing such scenarios and the fundamental subject of this tutorial. To really understand the difference between a game and an individual agent's decision problem, let's look at an example. Assume you live alone and are deciding what to cook for dinner. You go home, you open your refrigerator, you see you have some chicken, some spices, and you decide to make an Italian chicken. Now this is great because you are coordinating the entire dinner, you make some nice sides, and your dinner is very tasty because I know you're a good cook. Now, imagine a scenario where you're cooking with your friend, and you want to make the same Italian chicken. But what if your friend is making Chinese side dishes? I have to tell you, that would not be a dinner that I'd want to eat. Not very harmonious. What you have to do is you have to coordinate with your friend. You have to let your friend know that you're making Italian chicken so that they make an Italian side dish. This is known as a coordination game, and in fact, is a canonical example of a game that you would learn in an introductory game theory course. Even in this simple example, the second case in which you have to coordinate is much more complicated than the first. In the first case, you only care about cooking the tastiest meal, and you don't really think about how the chicken is going to react to you. In the second scenario, however, you care about not just what you make, but how your dish works with your friend's dish. The crucial element is that at the same time, your friend is also going through a similar decision-making process. This is sometimes known as a multi-agent optimization problem, and forms the essence of what is called a strategic scenario. And we use game theory to analyze strategic scenarios. For those of you familiar with decision theory, one similarity between game theory and single-agent decision problems is that we assume agents are rational utility maximizers. By utility maximizers, we just mean that agents choose the action that is best for them. By rational, we mean that they don't make mistakes in choosing that action. Now, if this sounds funny to you or unreasonable, that's okay. The second tutorial in this series will cover behavioral game theory, which is what happens when we relax these assumptions. If you're coming to this tutorial, you're probably interested in complexity science and are wondering, why does a complexity scientist need to know game theory? The long and short of it is that game theory can be used as a building block for larger complex models. For example, one complex system that we're interested in is cities. We might be interested in the migration patterns. We might be interested in the business patterns. We might be interested in the scaling of cities. And in fact, one other element of cities we might be interested in is the traffic flows. But if you think about it, traffic is the outcome of a game. Why? Well, it is people, or maybe even robots, making decisions about where and when to drive. In a famous example known as Bray's paradox, we can use game theory to show that adding a road to a traffic network can actually increase the amount of delays. This is just one of the many examples of how game theory can provide insight into a complex system. Other examples include air traffic control systems, national security, environmental regulation, stock markets, and computer networks. Unfortunately, we won't be able to cover all of these in this tutorial, but we will certainly touch on a few. Given the wide range of game theory applications, what will we be covering in this course, and what is our goal? We will begin by introducing main definitions in standard game theory courses. These include strategies, payoffs, utilities, and of course, equilibrium. And after laying this foundation, we'll work through several examples that will illustrate key phenomena that appear in a wide variety of games. All but one of these lessons only requires basic algebra, while one optional lesson requires calculus. In general, the goal of this course is to build a foundational understanding of game theory so that those interested in incorporating game theoretic aspects into their complex systems model would feel comfortable doing so. If you get stuck, remember there are quizzes to help guide you along the way, and I really hope you enjoyed these videos.